Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum, my dear students. How are you all? I hope you all are fine and taking great care of yourselves. Here I am, your computer teacher, and today is your lesson 6. So let's begin. So the chapter that we will do today is chapter number 7, the Internet, from page number 143 till 148.
Okay, the material that you have to arrange for this lesson is a lead pencil, eraser, highlighter, computer book, notebook, a blue marker, blue ink pen, and a ruler.
Dear students, please open page number 143 of your computer book. So before starting our today's lesson, let's have a look on previously discussed. In our previous lesson, we discussed about chapter number 7, the Internet. We discussed history of Internet, Internet service provider, and some companies that provide us Internet services, World Wide Web, web server, and some web browser. I hope these all topics are clear to you and there is no any kind of difficulty. Okay, now let's have a look on objectives of our today's lesson. After the completion of lesson, you will be able to know about web page, website, URL, uniform resource locator, assessment zone, question answer, and some higher order thinking skills. So dear students, please open page number 143. Here is a topic, web page. The pages that make up the World Wide Web are known as web pages. A web page is created using a language called hypertext markup language. So, जैसे कि आप किसी भी चीज को बनाने के लिए सबसे पहले उसका material इकट्ठा करते हैं, same ऐसे ही किसी भी website को बनाने के लिए उसका rule follow करना पड़ता है और एक website को बनाने के लिए जो language use की जाती है वो है hypertext markup language. It can be accessed using a web browser. आप किसी भी वेब ब्राउजर को यूज करते हुए वेबसाइट को एक्सेस कर सकते हैं. वेब ब्राउजर जैसे कि गूगल क्रोम, मोजिला फायरफॉक्स, सफारी एंड मेनी अदर. द पेजेस में कंटेन टेक्स्ट, इमेजेस, ऑडियो, वीडियो एंड लिंक्स टू अदर वेब पेजेस कॉल्ड हाइपरलिंक्स. अ हाइपरलिंक मे बी अ टेक्स्ट और पिक्चर. व्हेन यू मूव द माउस पॉइंटर ओवर अ हाइपरलिंक, द माउस पॉइंटर टेक्स द शेप ऑफ अ हैंड. So basically, hyperlinks are the links. When you click on these links, then you connect with another website. Website. A location on the web server is called a website. A website is a collection of related pages linked to one and other. Basically, website जो है वो बहुत से pages के साथ connect होती है, ठीक है? The home page is the first page of a website. जब भी आप किसी वेबसाइट को ओपन करते हैं तो जो भी पहला पेज आपके पास ओपन होता है उसको होम पेज कहते हैं. उसके बाद जितने भी पेजेस होते हैं वो इस वेबसाइट के मेन्यू में होते हैं और आप उनको इजीली एक्सेस कर सकते हैं. इट गेट्स डिस्प्लेड इन द ब्राउजर विंडो व्हेन अ वेबसाइट इज ओपन. इट यूजुअली कंटेन लिंक्स टू अदर सेक्शंस और पेजेस ऑफ द वेबसाइट एंड एक्ट एज द स्टार्टिंग पॉइंट फॉर विजिटर्स. सो आई होप नाउ ईच एंड एवरीथिंग क्लियर ऑन दिस टॉपिक. And please highlight some important points. Okay, now on page number 143, here are some interesting informations for you. Tim Berners-Lee is known as the father of the World Wide Web. So he is the first one who created a website. Jean Armour Polley, a librarian by profession, coined the term surfing the net. So he introduced the term surfing the net. The first graphical web browser to become popular was NCSA Mosaic. Here, NCSA stands for National Center for Supercomputer Applications. Next is URL, Uniform Resource Locator. A URL is the address of a web page or any other resource on the World Wide Web. Basically, URL, Uniform Resource Locator, is the address of any web page that you want to access. So here are some examples of URLs. You can see here, first example, www.google.com. This is the proper address of this website. Whenever you access Google, then you have to remember this address of the website. So same like this, you can also access Yahoo by using this address. So dear student, please open page number 144 now. To access a web page, you type the URL of the website or any other web page on the address bar of the browser window. So in figure 7.10, you can see here an internet browser is open, and below title bar here is address bar, and a proper address of a website is given here. A URL is made up of three parts. The first part of the address is the protocol being used. So here you can see in address bar, HTTPS is known as protocol, means that it's first part of URL. The second part of the address is the name of the server which has the resource or page to be accessed. So again in address bar you can see www. Basically it is the name of the server you want to access a website. So World Wide Web is the name of the server which provide you resource, means it will provide you the website that you want to access. So the third part of the address is the complete path of the file on the server. As you want to access google.com, so it's complete path of the file on the server. If a user types the URL http://www.computerhope.com keys htm in the address bar of a browser, it means that the user wants to access the page keys htm located on the server www.computerhope.com using the HTTP protocol. So whenever you want to access a website, you have to complete these three parts of a URL. So here in did you know, these days the protocol name is prefixed with the letter S as in HTTPS in the URL. In this, S stands for secure. This implies that secure and encrypted communications between your browser and the website will be established. So here you can see in address bar here a protocol HTTPS. S stands for secure, means that the website that you want to access is secure and encrypted. I hope now each and everything clear to you, and please highlight some important points regarding this. So here on page number 144 is the practice zone for you. This practice zone contains some fill in the blanks. First one is a software called Dash is required to access the website. So the answer is web browser. Links on a web page are known as hyperlinks. The first page of a website is known as home page. Dash and Dash are examples of web browsers. Google Chrome and Mozilla Firefox are examples of web browsers. A Dash stores a website, web server. The address of a web page or any other resource on the World Wide Web is called Dash, URL. Now next here is recap zone. By reading this recap zone, you can recap your all concept that we have discussed in this chapter. Next, a checklist is given. Put a tick against the concept you have understood and a cross against the one that you need help. Here some concept from this lesson are given, and the concept that you understand, put a tick in front of that concept, and the concept that you don't understand and you need help in it, put a cross against it. So dear students, please open page number 146 now. Here is an assessment zone for you. This assessment zone contains some fill in the blanks and some MCQs. So first of all, we will do fill in the blanks. First one is computers can be connected to each other to form a network. Second one is the World Wide Web is also referred to as www. In order to access the internet, we need a connection from an ISP, Internet Service Provider. Web pages are created using a language called HTML, Hypertext Markup Language, as we discussed in today's lesson. Next, fifth one is a dash is the address of a web page, URL, Uniform Resource Locator. Next, second part of this assessment zone is choose and tick the correct answer. First one is a network that spans continent is called WAN. Second one is find the odd one out. Internet Explorer, Windows Explorer, Google Chrome, Mozilla Firefox. We have to find out odd one. So here is Windows Explorer. Third one is the dash is the worldwide system of interconnected networks of computers. Computer area network, internet, a web browser and website. So the correct answer is internet. Fourth one is the internet is an example of dash. LAN, MAN, WAN, PAN. So the answer is WAN, Wide Area Network. Fifth one is a computer that stores the web pages and processes the request made by client is called web server, web browser, HTTP, website. The correct answer is web server. So please tick on the correct answer on your computer books. Okay, now on page number 147, here is the C part of assessment zone, which is look at the figure below and answer the questions. Here a figure of website is given here and we have to answer some questions. First one is, which of the following does the figure show? A web server, a web page, World Wide Web, or the internet? Basically, Wikipedia is the web page, so you will click on a web page. Second one is, which computer language is used to create it? As we discussed in our today's lesson, HTML, hypertext markup language, is required to create a web page. So HTML basically is used to create it. Third one is, find and write down the URL shown in the figure. So you have to write here URL. As we discussed in our today's lesson about URL, URL has three parts and we can see it in address bar. So when you will see in address bar, a proper address of this website is there and you have to write here proper address like this. Next, D part of this assessment zone contains some answer questions and we have done some answer question in our previous lessons. And in today's lesson, we will do question number 4 and 5. So dear students, now open page number 148. Here are some higher order thinking skills and these are very interesting. Find the secret term in the sixth column that encompasses all the internet terminologies by answering the following questions. So here some statements are given and by reading these statements, you have to solve this puzzle. So let's start. A software that lets you access the web page on the web server and acts like a web client. So here you will write web browser. Second one is the first page of the website that is displayed in the browser when a website is opened. So the first page, as we discussed, is known as home page. Third one is the address of a web page or any other resource on the World Wide Web. So it's URL, Uniform Resource Locator. Fourth one is the language used to develop web pages. It's HTML, hypertext markup language that is used to create a web page. Fifth one is a collection of related web pages that are stored on a web server are known as website. So you will write in fifth puzzle website. Sixth one is a company that provides internet access to users. So we know that the company that provides us internet services is known as Internet Service Provider, ISP. Seventh one is a network set up by the US Department of Defense that laid the foundation of the internet is ARPANET. Eighth one is a type of network spread over large distance, say across countries or even continents. It's WAN, Wide Area Network. Ninth one is the text or pictures on a web page that connect to other web pages are known as hyperlinks. So you will write in ninth puzzle hyperlinks. Tenth one is a computer that hosts website is web server. So you will write in tenth puzzle web server. I hope now each and everything regarding this lesson is clear to you and there is no any kind of difficulty. So please solve this puzzle on your books. Okay, now let's start our today's notebook work. So this is your computer notebook. Now open it. One side of your computer notebook is blank and the other side is lined. On this blank page, you will make title page of chapter number 7, the internet. And on this lined page, you will do your classwork. Dear students, please open your index page and prepare your index page like this. First of all, you will write serial number, then date, and after that you will write topic. Okay, now we will do our today's notebook work. So please write date and topic on your computer notebooks and also draw margin line. Write book exercise question answers as we will do some book exercise question answers. So question number 4 is, what is the significance of a URL? Name the various parts of a URL. As you know that we have discussed in our today's lesson about three parts of URL. So the answer is A URL is the address of a web page or any other resource on the World Wide Web. A URL is made up of three parts: protocol, second one is name of the server, and third one is complete path. Next, question number 5 is, what is WWW? Answer is, WWW stands for World Wide Web. WWW is a collection of interconnected pages. The various pages are connected using links. WWW is based on client-server architecture. Basically, WWW stands for World Wide Web. So I hope now you will do this work on your computer notebooks very neatly and carefully. So here I have a worksheet from your winter pack, and this worksheet belongs to your chapter number 7, the Internet. As we have done our complete chapter, so I hope now you will be able to solve this worksheet. So I request you to please solve this worksheet and paste it on your computer notebooks. Okay, here is an answer key of your computer worksheet. You can take help from this answer key while solving the worksheet. So question number 1 of your worksheet is fill in the blanks. First one is, the full form of WWW is World Wide Web. Second one is, a group of computers connected together make a network. Third one is, a computer network that usually covers a large area than land is known as MAN, Metropolitan Area Network. Fourth one is, the internet is also known as network of networks. Fifth one is, companies use internet to advertise their products is known as e-commerce. Sixth one is, Dash is a company that provides internet access to customers, ISP, internet service provider. Seventh one is, Google Chrome is an example of web browser. Okay, next, question number 2 of your computer worksheet is, choose the correct answer. First one is, a location on the web server is called website. Second one is, the home page is dash page of the website. First, highlighted, last, middle. So tick on first. Home page is first page of website. Third one is, which of the following is a popular internet service provider in Pakistan? PTCL, URL, WWW, ARPANET. So tick on PTCL. Fourth one is, the introductory page of the website is dash, Chrome, URL, browser, home page. Tick on home page. Fifth one is, links on a web page are known as autofill, hyperlinks, hypertext, within. So please tick on hyperlinks. Question number 3 is, in circle, T for true and F for false statements. So first one is, LAN is limited to a local area. It's true because LAN is limited to a local area or specific area. Second one is, a web server did not store a web page. It's false. Third one is, a web page is created by using HTML language. It's true because to create a web page, we require HTML hypertext markup language. Fourth one is, internet is a worldwide system of interconnected networks. It's true. Fifth one is, WAN is a network that did not cover a wide area. It's false because WAN covers a wide area. So I hope now each and everything regarding this worksheet is clear to you, and please solve this worksheet and paste on your computer notebooks. So dear students, I hope now each and everything regarding today's lesson is clear to you and there is no any kind of difficulty. So here I have some tasks to do for you. First one is, read the chapter from page number 143 till 148 carefully and highlight important points. You have to read your chapter very carefully and also highlight some important points. Second one is, learn and write question answers. You have to learn and write question answers that we did in our today's lesson. Third one is, learn assessment zone. You have to learn assessment zone from your computer book. I hope now you will do this task very efficiently and do your computer notebook work very carefully and neatly. So here I have an interesting information for you regarding our today's lesson, the internet. The first graphical web browser to become popular was NCSA Mozilla. Here, NCSA stands for National Center of Supercomputer Applications.
I hope that today's lesson was helpful for you and you have understood each and every point. I will see you in my next one. Till then, take care. Allah Hafiz. Stay home, stay safe.